Here I'm going to show you how to start creating your own custom profile. We can do most of these steps right through the front end of ColorByte. So if we double click and open our front end, now if we go up to Options and down to Advanced Calibration Wizard, this will guide us through most of the steps we need to creating ICC profiles. We have the option to create a new print mode for a selected media or to refine profiles for an already selected print mode. Here I'm going to start a new print mode. Instead of printing ICC targets for an existing print mode or altering ICC targets for an existing print mode, we click Next. Now, since I'm printing off a 1324, I will go down to my 1324 driver, and now I'll enter a name of my new profiled print mode. Here I'll just call it DCS test print mode. Now you need to clarify a starting point. So I want a resolution of 2880 by 1440, and if I know that the printer options under 2880 1440 IR4 graphics is where I want to start, then I'll select that. And you'll see down here all the printer options are selected for me. Here we're using a gray tag I1 IO table and scanner. I can set my ink set and my category and media description to whatever I'm profiling on. Here I want to change my page size. This is the size of the media that you're putting through your printer. The largest size for the scanner I'm using is 12 by 9. So I will cut down 12 by 9 sheets of my material and print to those. We also want to adjust our ink limits. I know that my base ink limit should be around 150 for the type of material I'm printing on. So I'll set that to 150. Once we hit print, the linearization targets will automatically go into my 1324 queue. Here we see on the right a preview of our linearization targets already set up for printing. That is, the ICCs have been deselected and the max ink levels have been linearized. Now we want to go back into our front end and our calibration wizard. Once the linearization targets have been printed onto your material, you are now ready to scan them. If I hit start reading, my scanner will start calibrating. Here we see it'll scan all my columns and rows. I will select the three registration points so the scanner knows where to scan. I'll hit start reading and my strips will begin scanning. Obviously, for the sake of time, I've sped this process up. Once we're all finished scanning and we click next, our print mode, DCS test print mode, will now be saved in our queue. Now if we go back to our queue and we go to printers and manage print modes, we can come down to our DCS test print mode, double click, override our color adjustments, and we see here now we see our colors have been linearized for us. However, we should take note that sometimes it is difficult for the scanner to scan properly, and if that does happen, we will have to linearize by eye, which is a very time-consuming process, but is possible to do if the scanner can't read the targets correctly. Now, after linearizing, we have to create an output profile, or a .icm or .icc profile. At DCS, we use two different types of software to create output profiles depending on the media and the ink set being used. We can do this through the front end by continuing in the calibration wizard and printing targets just like we did with the linearization and scanning those and having Color Byte create an ICC profile for us. Or we can use a software known as Profile Maker 5.0 and the measure tool to create our own swatches and adjust separation curves and ink levels, neutralizing grays. We come here and we can generate our patches. Here is a target, two-sheet target with multiple colors for a four-color set. One of the benefits of using Profile Maker is that it allows us to profile more than four colors, whereas Color Byte only allows you to profile four colors. We can profile up to eight colors with Profile Maker. Once the targets are generated, we bring them into our queue, adapt our settings accordingly, and print our targets and scan them. Once they're scanned, the information is saved in a text file, and then we can open Profile Maker and allow Profile Maker to read that text file and create an ICC profile. Once the ICC profile is created, we then want to attach it to our print mode. This will have to be done manually if we use another application besides Color Byte. And here we can go to our folder where the ICC profiles are held. Once we attach the profile and we have all our settings and linearization corrected, we are now ready to print using the created profile.